You do have the right to request for data brokers to remove the info they have on you, but with the sheer amount of them, it would take an unimaginable amount of time to go through submitting a request for every single one. Thankfully, Incogni is here to solve that exact problem. They will help you protect your privacy and get your personal data off the market by contacting all these different data brokers on your behalf to ask for your personal data to be removed. Personally, I've tried before to go through requesting for my info to be removed from all these different places, and pretty quickly gotten disheartened and given up. It's like a never-ending game of whack-a-mole. As soon as you take care of one, another one crops up. I've had stalkers find out my personal info, and also dealt with a lot of general annoying spam phone calls, text messages, and emails. So I was super relieved to hear that something like Incogni exists to help with that exact problem. The first 100 people to use code goodnight at the link below will get 20% off Incogni. Protect your privacy today. Go to incogni.com/goodnight and use code goodnight to get your data taken off the market.
Hello. Are you waiting for the train? Would you mind if I wait with you? Thank you. You're very kind. I hate to be alone at night. Do you? It is very beautiful. Where are you headed? I see. Oh, me? I'm headed downtown as well. Meeting some friends, actually. Hope I won't be late. The trains, they usually run on time, don't they? Don't know what the trouble is tonight. Shouldn't be too much longer, hopefully. Quite a striking look to you. Do you get that often? Yes, I think it's in the eyes. Your eyes, they have a sparkle to them. It's delicate. And your hair is quite beautiful as well. You should keep it back. Can I show you? Well, if you were to tuck it back behind the ear like this, and then sweep it back over your neck, let it rest. Thank you. very good. Much, much better. The shape of your neck, it was entirely hidden. That's no good. You have such a stately look to your neck. Statuesque, really. Am I making you uncomfortable? Well, you look a bit tense, is all. I apologize. May I read something to you? I'll help to pass the time. Who knows how much longer it might be. Good. It's called The Dance of Death. Carrying bouquet and handkerchief and gloves. Proud of her height. As when she lived, she moves with all the careless and high-stepping grace and the extravagant courtesan's thin face. With slimmer waist, hair in a ballroom wooed, her floating robe in royal amplitude falls in deep folds around a dry foot shod with a bright flower-like shoe. That gems the sod. The swarms that hum about her collarbones as the lavicious streams caress the stones conceal from every scornful jest that flies her gloomy beauty and her fathomless eyes are made of shade and void with flowery sprays. Her skull is wreathed artistically and sways, feeble and weak on her frail vertebrae, O charm of nothing decked in folly vain. Who laugh and name you a caricature? They see not, they whom flesh and blood allure, the nameless grace of every bleached bare bone that is most dear to me, tall skeleton. Come you to trouble with your potent sneer, the feast of life, or are you driven here to pleasure's Sabbath by dead lusts that stir and goad your moving corpse on with a spur? Or do you hope when sing the violins and the pale candle flame lights up our sins to drive some mock eternal alembic of antique distress, still o'er the curved white trellis of your sides, the sateless wandering serpent curls and glides. And truth to tell, I fear lest you should find among us here no lover to your mind. Which of these hearts beat for the smile you gave? The charms of horror please none but the brave. Your eyes black, gull for awful brooding stir. Brings giddiness, the prudent reveler. Sees while a horror grips him from beneath. The eternal smile of 32 white teeth. For he who is not folded in his arms, a skeleton nor fed on graveyard charms, reeks not of fur below or paint or scent, when horror comes the way that beauty went. Oh, irresistible with fleshless face, say to these dancers in their dazzled race, proud lovers with the paint above your bones, ye shall taste death, musk-scented skeletons. Withered and tenuous dandies with plump faces, ye varnished cadavers and grey love laces, ye go to lands unknown and void of breath, drawn by the rumor of the dance of death, from scene's cold quays to the burning stream. See with the open sky the angel's sinister trumpet raised on high, in every clime and under every sun, death laughs at ye, mad mortals, as ye run, and oft perfumes herself with myrrh like ye, and mingles with your madness. Still nothing. Do you think maybe the schedule changed? Perhaps some sort of malfunction. The train could have broken down somewhere, I suppose. Maybe it's time to make other plans. Yes, I'm quite bored. Oh, it's starting to rain. Do you have an umbrella? No? I can share. No, it's no trouble at all. Don't worry. There's more than enough room under here for the both of us, I'd say. I don't mind. Do you? Good. I am terribly surprised to see someone like yourself. I'm surprised I haven't seen you before. Well, I'm happy to have found you now. What a lovely coat. You know, I do live not too far from here. You could come inside and dry, get warm.
I have a fireplace. I could make you some tea, some coffee even, some hot chocolate, or wine, if you like wine. What sort of things do you like to drink?
You have a lovely place. I think you would like it. There are some sinister characters that lurk around these parts. It'd be nice to get away from it all. Stay out here, all alone, do you? Of course not. I see a smudge. I see a smudge just here on your jaw. Will you let me take care of that for you? So, is anyone expecting you tonight? Are you meeting anyone? Good. Well, then you have no reason. No reason at all to avoid me. I think it's fate. Why else would we have crossed paths if not for you to come with me? What do you think of this fragrance? Do you like it? Do you find it alluring? Intoxicating? Does it make Surprise me if you haven't. A scent like that is hard to find. It's rare. It's special. Something quite precious. You smell that. You even have to try. You're not wearing any sort of fragrance, are you? That's just the way you smell. Lucky you. It must make you quite popular. Have you ever met anyone like me before? Anyone who lingers too close for too long? Seems a bit. And there you are. Are you lonely? A lonely person? I can fix that. If you'd let me. It's dangerous here, but I could bring you somewhere safe, somewhere good, where nobody would find you. Yeah.